Hi everyone. Today let's learn to use handwriting.net's newest tool for creating and editing drafts. To begin, let's start with draft number 34239. There it is. Now let's add a plain weave border to all four sides of this draft. First, I'm going to straighten the treadling because it'll make the draft easier to work with for adding borders. So I will click View, Straight Treadling, and now I'm going to click Tools, and you'll see there's a new draft editor button here. We'll use that. Okay, so this will let you edit virtually any part of the draft directly except the drawdown. You can click on the tie-up, you can click on the threading, the treadling. You can also click and drag. If you want to set more than one cell at a time, you can do that. Or you can click and drag to clear too. In the tie up, when you click and drag, it will toggle the cells. And then the threading, it'll just set them, or the treadling. All right, so let's add some shafts to the tie up, and let's also add some treadles because that's where we're going to put our border. So we'll choose tie up and add shaft. And now we'll hover over the tie up. And where we click, it shows where the shaft will be added. So we'll add two at the very top. And now we'll choose tie up, add treadle. And we'll add two at the very right. Okay, now let's fill the tie up in to have our plain weave border. There we go. All right, so now let's set the warp threads and the weft threads to use the border. We'll add the threads we need for the border first. So we'll go to threads, we'll choose add thread, and for the right hand side border, we'll add three threads or four threads at the very beginning. And then we'll do the same thing on the left for the left border. And now we'll do the top. Now we'll do the bottom. Okay, now let's fill in those new threads in the threading and in the treadling, and we'll have the border. So we're going to use the top two shafts, the new ones that we added for the border. And there's the right border, and let's do the same thing on the left. And now let's do the top border. Now let's do the bottom one. There it is. Our draft has a new plain weave border on all four sides. So one last thing, we can compact this to seven shafts and eight treadles. This button is only here when the tie-up has duplicate rows or duplicate columns. You can remove those, and that way you can weave it on a loom that's got fewer shafts or fewer treadles. So let's do that. And you'll see that it kind of restructures the whole draft to change the tie up, but what it will weave is the same, and it put the borders in the first two shafts and the first two treadles instead of at the top. So it rearranged the whole thing. But now you could weave this on a loom that had eight treadles and just seven shafts. Okay, so for anything done within the draft editing tool, you need to save your work afterwards if you don't want to lose it. And to do that, click Draft, and then Download, and then choose one or more of these options. So download the draft WIF. That downloads a weaving information file that you can load back into this tool or into any other weaving software that you have. Or you can just draw down, you can download a drawdown image. And that will download the picture that you see here on the screen. And then you can print it, tape it to your loom and weave, or put it in a book or whatever you do with your printouts. So, all right, now that we've done that, let's edit another draft on the site. Let's work with number 54254. Just just kind of a plain little twill draft. And with this one, let's change it a lot. Instead of just adding borders, let's change the tie up and let's give it a completely different threading and a completely different chartering too. And maybe change the number of repeats that we see. So let's change the tie up first. And for this, I'm just gonna click a few times, actually tools, draft editor. We'll change the tie up. Maybe, let's see, something like, I don't know, that. And now let's click and drag across some cells to toggle all of them at once. There, that looks good. And maybe just set a couple more. Okay, that's a neat draft like it is, but I wonder what it would look like if it had a point threading and a point chartering instead. So we can add those really easily. We can just click and drag across the warp threads. And there's a partial repeat at the end now, but don't worry about that. We'll see how to take it out in just a second. All right, that looks good. Now we could do the same thing down here, or we could copy and paste part or all of the threading into the treadling. So let's do that. Let's choose threads, copy and paste. And now I can click and drag, and it will let me select a region of this to copy. So in this case, I'm going to do the whole thing, but we could just do part of it if I wanted. And there, now I got the whole thing. Now I can move that down here and just click and it pastes it right in. Okay, cool. So there's what it looks like with a point treadling and a point threading. And I like that a lot better, actually. So now let's get rid of that partial repeat. There's a new repeats tool that automatically removes partial repeats and you can select the number of repeats that you want. There's also a new tools button on all the tools pages, and this will move a draft between tools without having to download it and upload it in between. So let's use that. We'll click tools. And now I'm going to go to the new draft repeats tool. And it will ask me if I want to save my work first. I'm not going to save it right now, but we could. So here's the repeats tool. And you'll notice the partial repeat is gone. But if we wanted that for some reason, in some cases, a draft might actually have a partial repeat at the end that's part of the pattern. When it finds and removes one, it will give you the chance to put it back like this if you want to. But I don't want to put it back. I want it gone, so we'll leave it gone. Now let's change the number of repeats from 2 to 3. There, we can even make it more. We can make it 7. And this will work with any draft on the site or any new draft that you create with this tool. Okay, let's put it back to 3 because that's what I actually wanted. All right, now let's go back to the draft editor, tools draft editor. And now we can edit it some more. I'm gonna make one more change to it. We'll just change the colors. We'll make it maybe, I don't know, dark green. That looks good. So now I'll go to colors, replace colors, and click on the blue and it all turns to green. Now you'll notice if you're familiar with our color editor that this looks very similar. In fact, the draft editor will do everything the color editor does, but the color features are all organized under this button to make room for them. So if you know how to use the color editor already, you can make color changes here too, which I just did. Okay, so again, if we wanted to save our work for this draft, we would have to click draft, download, and download draft WIF, or you could download an image of it. But if we don't do that, we go somewhere else, we're going to lose it. So. Okay, let's do a new draft from scratch, a draft that doesn't yet exist. To create that, you go to the drafts menu at the top, and then you choose tools and create new draft. You can also choose your drafts and create new draft. It will do the same thing. So we'll do tools, create new draft. And now it asks for a title, and this is only used if you download the draft that uses a title as part of the file name so you can identify it later. So I'm just going to call mine KB Demo 1. Or maybe here. There. Okay, so let's give this draft 4 shafts, 4 treadles, and maybe 36 warp threads and 36 weft threads. You can also choose for the threading 3 options, none, which means you're going to have to fill the whole thing in, or you can make it straight to begin with or point. Same thing with treadling. So in this case, let's choose none. I'll fill all those in. So we'll hit create draft, and now we come to the draft editor, but it's completely empty because there's no draft yet. So let's make one. So I'm going to click on the tie-up first. You can fill this in any order. I'm just doing the tie-up first because that's what came to mind. Okay, that looks good for the tie-up. Now let's add a threading. So here I'm going to click on shaft 1. I'm going to click and drag to fill up 1 through 4, and then I'm going to click on 4. So that's going to be my threading. Now I want to repeat that throughout both the threading and the treadling. So let's do threads, copy. We'll copy those. Now I'm going to paste them in a bunch of times. Okay, whoops. There we go. Now I like the way that looks. Let's make this tromp as writ. So I'm going to copy all of those instead of just one group and paste all of them into the weft threads. Nice. Okay. Now let's mess with the color pattern a little bit. It's black and white right now. We'll leave it black and white for the moment. But let's make every other group of 6 threads alternate colors. So we'll choose white. We'll leave the first 6 black. We'll make the next 6 white. Leave the next 6 black. Make the next 6 white. And so on until we get them all. Oops. Made a mistake there. I'm going to click undo. Undo will undo the last operation no matter what it was. There, I like that. Okay, so now let's do the same thing in the weft, but I'm going to copy all of those colors and paste them in rather than doing them one group at a time like I just showed. So we'll choose colors, copy and paste colors, and now I'm going to click and drag across all those to select them all, and now we can paste them in down here. There. So it made a cool pinwheel design. That's pretty neat. Now let's add some more colors to it. So let's maybe get a nice dark purple. That looks good. And maybe a kind of amber yellow color. About like that. And maybe a nice bright red. Okay, so let's take everything that's black and make it purple. So we'll choose colors and replace, and the purple is selected here. So now I'm going to click on black warp threads and on black weft threads, and the black turned purple. Cool. Okay, so now let's make everything that's white this amber color. Same thing, we'll click that to select it. Now the red isn't in the pattern yet, but let's add it. So let's click on the red. Okay. There. Our draft is done. So that is a brand new 4 shaft color and weave pattern that was made completely on the site using the new draft editor. And again, if we wanted to save our work, we would have to click draft, download, download with. Okay, let's do one more. Now for this, let's make a new 16 chef pattern and fill it in completely from scratch. So we'll go to Drafts, Tools, Create New Draft. And this time I'm going to call it KB 16 Shaft Sample. And we'll give it 16 shafts. We'll give it 16 treadles. And then for warp threads, maybe, I don't know, 60. Okay, and this time, let's initialize the threading to point and the treadling also to point. Okay, create draft. And there is an empty 16 shaft draft. So let's start filling in the tie up. I'm going to click and drag across 4 cells at a time to make these little squares. Whoops. There we go. So I'm going to put a bunch of these squares in. So instead of clicking and dragging individually, now I can copy part of the type and paste that in. So I'm going to do tie up, copy paste. We'll select the part we want to copy. And now wherever I click, that'll get pasted in. So let's put in one there, and one there. Cool. Now I can click and drag to click and drag to set some cells in the type like we did before. So maybe like that, and then I'm going to click and drag to set some lines of cells too. That looks good, and let's do the same thing up here. It's looking pretty good. Let's make a few more changes to it. Let's maybe set some of these, I don't know. Okay, and maybe those squares look kind of dense. Let's lighten them up a bit. That looks good. Let's do the smaller ones too. There, I'm liking that. Okay, so let's change the colors. Maybe we'll make this blue. Okay, and now let's do repeats. So we'll go to Tools, Draft Repeats, and maybe we'll make 3 instead of 2. There it is. Let's make it a little bit smaller so we can see more at a time. That looks good with 3 repeats. Okay, let's go back to the editor. Make it a little smaller again. There we go. So there it is. We made a 16 shaft pattern completely from scratch in just a few clicks. So that's all there is to the basics of the handweaving.net draft editor. There are more things in these buttons that I didn't show, but they're pretty self-explanatory. You shouldn't have any trouble figuring them out. And please go make some beautiful things. Thanks for watching.